Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Tyrone back with Tech Life. Great article here from the T-Mo News. I'll leave a link to it in the description so you guys may check it out. So T-Mobile has been winning this part of the J.D. Power Award for several years now. And this one comes down to customer care. T-Mobile in 2024, again, or this is probably taken mostly in 2023, but they will probably win it again this year. And I know some of you have had bad experiences with T-Mobile customer care, and I'll probably see that in the comments. And I've had bad experiences too with T-Mobile's customer care, I'll be honest. But the worst experience that I've ever had with T-Mobile customer care is still better by far than any of the worst with Verizon and AT&T. My God. Oh my God. Like, it's not even close. And I didn't, and the worst experience that I had with T-Mobile's customer care I didn't even feel it was that bad. They just couldn't get it resolved. And it was with the trade-in credit. A year ago, I had an iPhone 13. I traded it in. It went to the warehouse. I got confirmation, but it was never actually removed off the account. I was still being charged for that device and a new device. That was about the worst experience that I've had. And they couldn't get a solution. Eventually, it got resolved, but that was about the worst. The one that I had with AT&T, man, when they kept charging my credit card and they couldn't refund it, I mean, that was a horrible experience. It took me like 3 weeks to get that money back. And to this day, still, I haven't gotten the full amount. I mean, it's night and day between the two. Verizon, too. Verizon, I had a huge issue that could not be resolved. I got overseas reps. It was just a big nightmare. So everyone's experience is different. But in my opinion, dealing with T-Mobile for the last like 6-7 years when it comes to customer care, although T-Mobile is trying to make it to where you don't have to call as much. They're adding more features to the app so you can fix some of these problems through your app. So that's a good thing. Less time spent calling customer care. It's just better overall. So I don't call them much unless there is an issue. But I know some are calling T-Mobile every other day for whatever reason. But for me, I call T-Mobile's customer care maybe like once every 6 months or so, if that. And that's if no issues come about. But so far, I've had good experiences with T-Mobile's customer care. And like I said, even the worst experience I've had is still not anything close to what I dealt with AT&T and Verizon. And I think most of you will agree, everyone is going to have a bad experience with any customer care, not just in wireless, anywhere you call. It's gotten bad over the years. But but at least we know T-Mobile tries their hardest to have the best customer satisfaction when it comes to customer care. J.D. Power again showing that's happening. And how many consecutive times? 13. This is the 13th consecutive time that T-Mobile has won this, and I don't think they'll be dethroned anytime soon. I hope this never gets to the point where it does get to where Verizon and AT&T are with customer care. Now, I'm not saying every single customer care call with Verizon and AT&T are bad, but just the experience part of it, I've had the worst experiences with those two. And it actually got me to leave them as my primary, each of them, because I've had such bad experiences with AT&T. One time I was at the 50% paid off, but they still wouldn't let me upgrade to a new device because I wasn't at the 18th month of being in that device, but it was already 50% paid off. It was, like I said, it was just a nightmare, worst experience ever, and that got me to leave them. So let me know your thoughts in the comments. Let me know your experience. Let me know if you think T-Mobile is the best in customer care. If you're new to the channel, like, share, subscribe, follow my social media outlets. This is Tyrone with Tech Life. See y'all in the next one. Peace.